It's our big story at 10. A Green Bay man is behind bars tonight, accused of murdering his live-in girlfriend. 31-year-old Richard Garnaby faces first-degree intentional homicide. Last night, officers found Garnaby's girlfriend dead in the basement of this home at 944 Christiana Street on Green Bay's west side. Police are not releasing the victim's name or how she was killed. NBC 26's Brian Miller is in the newsroom and begins tonight's coverage.
Police say Garnaby went to a friend's house Saturday afternoon, sobbing and covered in blood. And when the friend called 911, police showed up to his house and found his girlfriend dead in their basement apartment.
Police arrived at this Christiana Street home Saturday for a welfare check of a 26-year-old woman. When investigators found inside, turned the visit into a murder investigation.
He turned around and started running towards the house. The officer stopped him, detained him in handcuffs, searched the house and located the female victim and subsequently arrested the suspect.
Police say the couple began arguing and the fight turned violent. The victim's 4-year-old son was home at the time. Officers say Garnaby locked the boy in the bathroom during the alleged murder. Neighbors say it was strange to see their block become a crime scene.
I was in shock yesterday, and actually everybody in this neighborhood was shocked yesterday because they looked so nice. It was really a surprise for everybody here.
I'm concerned. You know, I mean, we live in a neighborhood that there are such people.
Green Bay police say domestic violence crimes happen every day.
What happened yesterday was the worst case scenario. It was a homicide that involved a domestic relationship and an argument that precipitated into the homicide.
It's a crime police say did not have to end like this, with a family grieving and a child without a mother.
Police would not say if weapons were involved or how the victim died, but an autopsy is underway, and once that is completed, we should know more about how the victim died. In the newsroom, Brian Miller, NBC 26.